Deputy Brendan Howland.
Thank you, Kian Corla. Can I say, if the Taoiseach had intended to give reassurance to people in relation to A&Es, she's singularly failed to do that. A very simple sentence was required, that no A&E will be in any way adversely affected by anything that arises from this report. That's what's needed. I want to raise a different matter, if I can, Kian Corla. The HSE funds 1,900 voluntary agencies to a value of approximately 3.1 billion euros per year. 44 of these agencies, accounting for annual expenditure of 2.5 billion euros, are funded under Section 38 of the Health Act. The remainder, of which there are 1,800 approximately, are part-funded under Section 39 of the same Act. The governance context in which the HSE engages with Section 39 agencies is different from which applies in the case of Section 38. For example, the employees of Section 39 agencies are not public servants, are not members of the public sector pension scheme, and unlike those in Section 38 agencies, are not directly bound by Department of Health consolidated pay scales. In 2009, the HSE developed a national standard governance framework for non-statutory sectors. In 2010, under that framework, service arrangements were introduced between the HSE and Section 38 agencies. And in 2013, the HSE sought to enhance the governance arrangements in place for these agencies and to strengthen the direct relationship between the HSE and the boards of each agency. Part of this enhanced governance was the introduction of an annual compliance process and annual meetings between the HSE and chairs of all Section 38 agencies. So can I ask the Taoiseach whether she can confirm, firstly, that all Section 38 agencies are in full compliance with the HSE requirements regarding board and corporate governance? Question one. Two, can you confirm that all agencies adhere now to Department of Health pay scales in all circumstances? Three, can you confirm that the chairs and directors of all Section 38 agencies have signed the compliance statement as is now required? Can you further confirm that all overpayments to individuals employed in these agencies have been notified and have been notified to the Department of Health have now ceased? And finally, can you confirm that the government is satisfied with the oversight arrangements that are now in place to monitor what is state expenditure of 3.8 billion euros?
Thank you, Deputy Howland. Taoiseach.
Thank you. Thank you, Deputy Howland. First of all, I would like to inform you that a review of all Section 38 providers is being conducted by external consultants. That is underway by the Department of Health at present. And the purpose of these reviews is to establish the standard of governance in place in these organisations and to confirm independently the very points that you raise in relation to governance practice and procedures accord with those set out in the respective annual compliance statements. And the reviews involve an examination of key governance processes and documents, including obtaining confirmation that internal financial controls and formal written financial procedures are in place in these organisations. Six of these reviews are currently underway, and the outcome of those reviews will inform the HSE's relationship with the agencies concerned and any further enhancements that's needed in relation to the overall governance framework that is required. The HSE provides funding in return for services to some 40 agencies under Section 38 and funding to a much wider group under the other section that you've raised, which is Section 39. The value of these relationships in terms of the money given by government is in the hundreds of millions. And of course, the history has been that, to begin with, these were rather informal arrangements. We've now moved to a point where they are far more formalised, and as you say, quite a number of changes in relation to governance have been made. The Minister for Public Expenditure spoke just earlier this morning in relation to the payments to Section 39 CEOs and the need to examine those and to see if they are in line with the FEMPI legislation. And he is following that up as we speak in relation to the agencies that you have spoken about.
Deputy Howland.
This matter has been teed up for some time, but the Tánaiste has not been able to answer very direct questions. Am I to understand that neither you nor the Minister for Health beside you can actually confirm that all the agencies that you fund are adhering to the Department of Health pay scales currently? That everybody employed in these agencies are paid in accordance with the pay norms set down by the Department of Public Expenditure? And secondly, can you or can you not confirm that overpayments that have been already formally notified to the Department of Health have ceased?
Thank you, Deputy Howland.
In relation to your first question, Deputy, about compliance, I am informed that the annual compliance statement has been signed by the agencies, but what the Department are currently doing is putting in another layer to examine precisely with external consultants to examine the area once again. But the statements have been signed, the compliance statements have been signed by all agencies. Agencies, and there is now further work being done to review the situation once again. As I said to you in relation to the what you're describing as the overpayments, the Minister for Public Expenditure has spoken about this today and said that his department is examining that situation right now, and I've no doubt the question of overpayments and whether current payments have been stopped. I understood from what he said earlier today that that was the situation, but he is following it up, and it does raise very serious concerns in relation to the compliance of certain organisations with the standards that have been laid down by government in relation to payment of people who are delivering services paid for by the taxpayer.
Thank you very much.